Please take a moment to think. How many of you have a mother, a father, a co-worker, a child, a friend, a neighbor, or someone in your life that's been touched by cancer? Hello, my name is Joe DePenta, and 4 years ago I retired from the National Hockey League after 11 professional seasons. I became a Stanley Cup champion in 2007 as a defenseman with the Anaheim Ducks. I joined the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society 2 years ago to make an impact on my local community here in Halifax, and because of the impact this disease has had on my family. As a part of my job now, I go to the IWK and QE2 hospitals bi-weekly to visit leukemia and lymphoma and myeloma cancer patients. Tonight I'm going to tell you about how your donations can empower, give hope, and resources to these patients through an inspirational project. I have come to realize that these patients and their families face a great number of difficulties. Some of them are uncertainty of survivorship, financial hardships, and depression. First, let me start with the difficulties patients face. 2 weeks ago, I met an 8-year-old girl at the IWK who was most of her hair was gone, had IVs hooked up, and whose family was wondering if she's going to make it to Christmas. Patients that I visit wanted to know the basics around survivorship. Is my daughter going to die? Am I going to live? Most of them are not thinking of much else. As a result, tests, follow-ups, and drug efficacy often fall through the cracks because they don't advocate for themselves within the system. This is a detriment to the patient's overall care and can hurt their chances of survivorship. 1 year ago, I met a 7-year-old boy from Glasgow diagnosed with leukemia. His parents had to drive to Halifax 3 days a week for chemotherapy. It was next to impossible for either parent to work, so both of them unfortunately had to go on unemployment. With less income, they also had to take extra travel expenses for the hospital visits. Getting cancer can be one of the most devastating financial blows that can happen to a family or an individual. Another friend of mine lost his 23-year-old brother 2 years ago after a 10-month battle with lymphoma. He commented about how his brother felt alone and forgotten by the diminishing number of visitations from his friends. He spent his last days living with depression. So how can you help? I want to deliver much-needed support directly to these patients and their families. I want to give blood cancer patients here in Halifax a care package called the Empower Pack. Each Empower Pack will be specifically tailored to each recipient and designed to empower patients through much-needed resources and hope. 100% of the funds that would come through tonight would go directly to this initiative. 0 to administrative costs, 100% go directly to the patients. Each pack will be ran with 100 women who care, so they understand that there are people in the community who are thinking of them. First, the pack will explain the basics around their survivorship and teach them the questions they need to ask their doctors to get the best possible care during their treatment. Patients need to understand that they need to be their own best advocates in our healthcare system. This will give patients empowerment, superior care, and a better chance at survivorship. Second, I want to alleviate some of the financial burden the patients and families experience. Resources and care package items will be included for each individual's needs. For example, a grocery card for a family or patient that's out of work. A gas card for a family required to drive a lot. Last, I want to remind these patients that they are not forgotten. Each pack will have a contact information from a mentor who has survived their exact diagnosis, their same gender and approximate age. And these mentors are crucial for giving them emotional support, hope, and to answer disease-specific questions they may have. There are people right here in our community that still care for them, and some of us are here tonight. Let me conclude with this. I know that this is an immense privilege for me to be involved to speak here tonight at this event, and to advocate for local blood cancer patients. I am inviting you to take action for a very worthy cause, to give hope, to give resources to the approximate 100 locals dealing with blood cancer. These people already face enough difficulties, uncertainty of survivorship, financial hardships, and depression. Think of a mother, a father, a co-worker, a child, a friend, a neighbor, or someone in your life who's been touched by this awful disease.